Good morning, children. It is so nice to see you all for this English class. Let's begin the first lesson, Unit 1, Prose, The Portrait of a Lady. It is written by Khushwant Singh. Now, the picture what you are viewing is, he is Mr. Khushwant Singh. Let's see something about him. Khushwant Singh is an Indian novelist and a lawyer. He studied at St. Stephen's College, Delhi and King's College, London. He joined the Indian Foreign Service in 1947. So he is a very learned person. Khushwant Singh is an Indian novelist and a lawyer. So by profession, he was a lawyer and he was a novelist also. And where did he study? He studied at St. Stephen's College, Delhi and King's College, London. He joined the Indian Foreign Service in 1947. As a writer, he is best known for his keen secularism, sarcasm and love for poetry. Secularism means about one thing. And what is sarcasm? Sarcasm means telling something in a very mocking way. Tamil solnona sarcasm na ilakaramaga, sarcastic. So I just want to define with a short sentence. The same sentence, by the tone you can identify how it is being said. Romba nalla irundhuchu. Romba nalla irundhuchu. See, the first one, when I said romba nalla irundhuchu, that is really true. And the second time I said, romba nalla irundhuchu. That is a sarcastic note. So, he is very famous for writing sarcastic things. And he had a love for poetry. So, he is a novelist. He is a learned man. And he is also a poet. He loved poetry. Though he didn't write poetries, he loved to read poems. He served as the editor of several literary and news magazines, as well as two newspapers. Khushwant Singh was awarded with Padma Bhushan in 1974, Padma Vibhushan by the Government of India and Sahitya Academy Fellowship by Sahitya Academy of India. See, I want you to take it into memory, these things about Khushwant Singh. First one, he is a novelist and a lawyer and he is famous for writing in a very sarcastic note. The third one you have to be very, very familiar is he was awarded with Padma Bhushan in 1974, Padma Vibhushan by the Government of India and Sahitya Academy Fellowship by the Sahitya Academy of India. The Mark of Vishnu. Now we are going to see some of his famous writings. The Mark of Vishnu, A History of Sikhs, The Train to Pakistan, Success Mantra, We Indians and Death at My Doorstep are some of his brilliant works. So, all his writings are, we can find so many things interesting in all his writings. One could enjoy whatever story we read by the writings of Khushwant Singh. Shall we move on to the lesson? Yes. Before I move on to the lesson, I want you to remember about few things about Khushwant Singh. Khushwant Singh is an Indian novelist, a lawyer. He studied in Delhi and London. Then what else? He is very famous for writing sarcastic notes. He loved poems and he was awarded with Padma Bhushan, Padma Vibhushan and Sahitya Academy Award. Yes, this is all about the writer Khushwant Singh. Now, we'll move on. I want you to know about the title, The Portrait of a Lady. So, what do you mean by portrait? Portrait means picture. What is portrait? Portrait is picture. So, now from this title, we can understand that Khushwant Singh wants to say something about a lady. And let's see in detail who that lady is. So, let's begin this lesson. My grandmother, like everybody's grandmother, was an old woman. So we all know grandma means usually an old woman. Grandmother is always old. So what he says is emphasizing, my grandmother, like everybody's grandmother, was an old woman. She had been old and wrinkled for the 20 years that I had known her. So maybe the writer was 20 years old when he had written this story. He says, all these years from my childhood, I know her as an old woman with wrinkled face. What do you mean by wrinkled? Surukko surukkamaga. Wrinkled means surukko surukkamana oru muham. Yes? Okay. She had been old and wrinkled for the 20 years that I had known her. People said that she had once been young and pretty and had even had a husband, but that was hard to believe. So here one can see the sarcastic note. Sarcastic means elakaramaga. So all the people, they grew old at one point of time, is it not? Illaya ellarum or kala kattathila vayadanavangala aayirvaanga. But here writer says people said that she had once been young and pretty. So naturally, if a lady is old, at her young age she would have been pretty and she would have definitely been young, because a child once born has to cross all the stages to attain the old age. Now he says people said that she had once been young, or kaalathila young, pretty. Pretty means alagaga. Pretty is a word which is used for women, whereas for men what will we say? Handsome, is it not? Ladies ku solrappa pretty nu solvanga, ponnungala solrappa she is pretty, adhe idu payangala solrappa eppadi solvom? Handsome. Now this old lady, what the writer says, had once been young and pretty, had even had a husband. So she was married, but that was hard to believe. Now this writer is making fun of that old lady, and he says that she was very pretty, she was very young, and she had a husband. And he says it was hard to believe. I don't think that all these things could have happened in her life, because from the birth, this author had seen this old lady as a old lady, and he had seen her only with wrinkles. My grandfather's portrait hung above the mantelpiece in the drawing room. So this old lady had a husband. So if this lady is the grandmother, her husband is probably the grandfather. My grandfather's portrait, portrait means picture, hung above the mantelpiece in the drawing room. Mantelpiece, this is called the mantelpiece. Mantelpiece means a fireplace, above the fireplace. So where was the picture hung? The author's grandfather's picture was hung above the mantelpiece. This is the mantelpiece. Yes, okay. And how was his look? He wore a big turban and loose fitting clothes. So his grandfather in the portrait, because from his birth he hasn't seen his grandfather, he has seen only his grandmother. The portrait alone he has seen. Now what is the appearance of the grandfather? He wore a big turban and loose fitting clothes. Now this is the mantelpiece. And his long white beard covered the best part of his chest, and he looked at least 100 years old. So this grandmother, what was the appearance of the grandfather? Grandfather, let's see, let's have a recap. He wore a big turban and a loose fitting clothes. Big turban and a loose fitting clothes. Next, his long white beard covered the best part of his chest, and he looked at least 100 years old. See, this is a grandpa with a long white beard, a turban, and see his long white beard, it grows near to his chest. So this may be the appearance. This is not the grandfather's picture. This, I just took a picture to show an old grandpa with a turban and a long white beard. Yes. And how did he look? He looked at least 100 years old. Maybe he too was looking very old. he did not look the sort of a person who would have a wife or children. So again, one can see the sarcastic note of this Khushwant Singh. This Khushwant Singh, first he said that his grand, he cannot imagine his grandmother was once young, a pretty woman, and who had a husband. Now he says about his grandfather that he did not look the sort of person who would have a wife or children. He looked as if he could only have lots and lots of grandchildren. So what was the look of the grandfather? This Khushwant Singh says that it is hard to believe that his grandfather who had a wife was young, but by the appearance of the grandfather, through the portrait which he had seen, he says he could only have lots and lots of grandchildren. Yeng grandfather ku young arndaru wife irundanga appadi la enakku nenaikka mudiyadhu. I can say that he had only lots and lots of grandchildren, nariya pera pulling da irukum, because he seems to be so old. Now where was the portrait hung? It was hung in the mantelpiece. Enga maati irundhuchu the portrait? What is a portrait? It is a picture. It was hung above the mantelpiece. Now what was the appearance of the grandfather? He wore a loose fitting dress, a big turban, long white beard covered the best part of his chest, and he looked at least 100 years old. As for my grandmother being young and pretty, the thought was almost revolting. Again he says he cannot believe his grandmother being a young and pretty woman. Yeng grandmother young ah irundanga pretty ah irundanga. He can't just think of a woman like that. She often told us of the games she used to play as a child. So his grandmother was a very good companion to the narrator. What he says, she often told us of the games she used to play as a child. See, nowadays these children, yes, the small children, we can see that they are often playing with their mobile phones. Even 2 years child, even a 1 year child, if you want to make the child silent, what parents do? They give the mobile phone in the hands of the children. Whereas in olden days they used to play lots and lots of games. உங்களுக்கு தெரியுமா தெரியல. Now you are in lockdown, so what do you do most of the time? You play with online games, you play with your mobile. But in the olden days there were lots of games where the children used to play outdoor. வீட்டு வாசல்ல விளையாடுவாங்க நல்லா. உங்களுக்கு தெரியும் தாயம் விளையாடலாம், then snakes and the ladder. Nowadays ludo is also played even in those days, and there were lots of games. So this grandmother used to share her experience about the about her childhood. That seemed quite absurd and undignified on her part, and we treated her it like the fables of the prophets she used to tell us. Now whenever we too may have grandparents at home, and they'll be telling the old stories. Now how do we react when they tell us the stories? We just get very wild. சொன்னதே சொல்லாதீங்க, அந்த காலத்து கதையெல்லாம் எங்களுக்கு வேண்டாம். வி ஜஸ்ட் சே ஸோ, இஸ் இட் நாட்? பிகாஸ் வி ஆர் நாட் இன்ட்ரெஸ்டட் டு லிசன் வாட் த ஓல்ட் பீப்புள் ஷேர் வித் அஸ். அண்ட் டு ஆஸ் இட் இஸ் ஆல் குவைட் அப்சர்ட். வாட் யூ மீன் பை அப்சர்ட்? அப்சர்ட் மீன்ஸ் ஸ்டூபிடிட்டி. அப்சர்ட் மீன்ஸ் ஸ்டூபிடிட்டி. டு ஆஸ் இட் வி ஃபீல் லைக் வெரி போர்ட். தட் சீம் குவைட் அப்சர்ட் அண்ட் அன்டிக்னிஃபைட் ஆன் அவர் பார்ட். And we treated it like the fables of the prophets she used to tell us. What do you mean by fables? Fables means a short story which carry moral. So this grandmother used to tell fables of the prophets she used to tell us. She always used to explain. Now I want you to remember two things. Nowadays people have two kinds. We all live in a nuclear family. What is a nuclear family? Nuclear family consists of a father, mother and few children. Whereas in a joint family, there were parents, grandparents, uncle, aunt, everyone was there. Now, as this story moves, we can understand that the narrator was living with his grandmother. So, it was a joint family, of course, and not as a nuclear family, how you all live nowadays. Now, this grandmother told fables. What do you mean by fables? Fables means a short story which carry moral. She had always been short and fat and slightly bent. Now, we have to remember the appearance of the grandfather. How was he looking? He was wearing a loose-fitting dress, a big turban, a long white beard, which was till his chest. And how was the grandmother looking? She had always been short and fat and slightly bent, because as we grow old, we won't be able to stand erect. Nimirndu nikkevo nadakkavo mudiyadu. So grandmother nrappa kattayam koon vilundirpaanga, slightly bent. She had always been short and fat and slightly bent. Her face was a crisscross of wrinkles running from everywhere to everywhere. How was her face? Crisscross of wrinkles. What do you mean by wrinkles? Surukam. See this picture. Now you are seeing an old lady with so many wrinkles on her face. Surukam. And you cannot find out from where this wrinkle starts and where it ends. It runs throughout her face. Is it not? Crisscross of wrinkles. So, the narrator's grandmother may be also looking like this. The face of an old lady with full of crisscross of wrinkles. Yes. First, she is short, fat and slightly bent. Her face was a crisscross of wrinkles running from everywhere to everywhere. See here, from everywhere to everywhere. Wrinkles are running from everywhere to everywhere. No, we were certain she had always been as we had known her. Old, so terribly old that she could not have grown older and had stayed at the same age for 20 years. So this author, as I said earlier, the narrator must have been 20 years of age when he had written the story. Because he says, for all these 20 years, I have seen this woman as an old woman with crisscross wrinkles running from everywhere to everywhere. She is short, she is fat, slightly bent, and I have never seen her young. Na young ave avangala paathadilla avanga, maybe na enak therinjadhilanda avanga eppadi mattume irukanga. Old, so terribly old, so terribly old. He is just emphasizing her old, how she was old. She could not have grown older. இதுக்கு மேல அவங்க கிளவி ஆகவே முடியாது. So he comes to a conclusion that is how an old woman can be. இதுக்கு மேல வயசானவங்க இருக்கவே முடியாதுன்றது, this is the conclusion, because he says his grandfather was, he looked as if he was 100 years old. Now when he tells about his grandmother, he says old, so terribly old that she could not have grown older and had stayed at the same age for 20 years. 20 varshama na paathirukken, and all these 20 years she was the same. She is the same, and she could never have been pretty. Again a sarcastic note. She could never have been pretty, but she was always beautiful. Ivanga romba pretty ah irundanganu solla mudiyadhu, but she was beautiful. Oru alagu irundhuchu. அந்த அழகு வந்து இளமையில தான் இருக்கணும்னு இல்லை. ஈவன் இன் ஓல்ட் பீப்புள் மே அப்பியர் பியூட்டிஃபுல். சி த அப்பியரன்ஸ் ஃப்ரம் த பிகினிங். ஹி சேஸ் ஷி இஸ் ஷார்ட், ஃபேட், ஸ்லைட்லி பெண்ட், வித் கிறிஸ் கிராஸ் ரிங்கிள்ஸ் ரன்னிங் எவ்ரிவேர். ஷி இஸ் ஓல்டர் அண்ட் ஆல் தீஸ் 20 இயர்ஸ் ஷி இஸ் ஓல்ட் அஸ் த சேம். அண்ட் ஃபைனலி ஹி சேஸ் வாட் டிட் ஹி சே? ஹி சேஸ் she is beautiful. She could never have been pretty, but she was always beautiful. அவங்க பிரிட்டியா இருந்தாங்களா என்னன்றது எனக்கு தெரியாது, பட் ஷி வாஸ் ஆல்வேஸ் பியூட்டிஃபுல், எப்போவுமே ஒரு அழகானவங்க எங்கள் கிராண்ட் மதர். ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் த டிஸ்கிரிப்ஷன் அபவுட் ஹிஸ் கிராண்ட் ஃபாதர் அண்ட் கிராண்ட் மதர். ஸோ அவங்க கிராண்ட் ஃபாதரை சொல்கிறப்ப, ஹி ஓர் லூஸ் ஃபிட்டிங் ட்ரெஸ், ஹி ஹேட் அ லாங் பியர்ட், ஹி ஹேட் அ லாங் பியர்ட், ஹி ஓர் அ டர்பன் அண்ட் ஹி லுக்ட் ஆஸ் இஃப் ஹி வாஸ் 100 இயர்ஸ் ஓல்டு. அண்ட் வேர் வாஸ் இஸ் போர்ட்ரேட் ஹங்? இட் வாஸ் ஹங் அபவ் த மேண்டல் பீஸ். Now, when he was telling about his grandmother, what does he say? Oh, crisscross wrinkles running everywhere. She is short, fat, and slightly bent. But finally, he concludes that she was always beautiful. Yen grandmother, romba alagana unga. She hobbled about the house in spotless white with one hand resting on her waist to balance her stoop and the other telling the beads of her rosary. She hobbled. Hobbled means walking unsteadily. What do you mean by hobbled? Walking unsteadily. I want you to take notes on the keywords. She hobbled means she walked unsteadily. She was old. Yeah, she was a fat lady. She was old and she was bent. So she cannot walk upright. So she hobbled, tadumari. She hobbled about the house. And how was her dress? In spotless white, with one hand resting on her waist. What is waist? Idup. To balance. So she was a very old lady. She was slightly bent. She hobbled. She walked unsteadily. And how was her dress? Spotless white, pure white, with one hand resting on her waist to balance her stoop. Stoop means bent. Stoop means bent. And the other telling the beads of her rosary. See the image at the side of the page. Rosary means jabamale. So when you could have seen people having the rosary in the jabamale kaila vechittu, they'll be telling prayers. So this lady, what she will do? She will always be chanting some mantras, telling some prayers to the Lord God. Her silver locks, locks means hair, her silver locks, because of her old age, all her hair has been turned grey, grey color. Appa vellamudi aayiruchu, and vellamudi nam author enna solraaru, her silver locks, locks endradhu surul surla avangalude thalamudi, her silver locks were scattered untidily over her pale, puckered face. Scattered untidily. It is not combed properly. Avanga thala olunga seevala. She is a very old lady. Avanga thala olunga seevala. Were scattered untidily over her pale. Pale means velirittu. Because of her old age, she was not able to eat properly. Her pale, puckered. Puckered means again wrinkled face. And her lips constantly moved in inaudible prayer. So she was doing something, a prayer. She was chanting mantras. She was telling prayer. Her lips was moving, but we cannot understand what she was praying. No one can understand. Only we can see the moving of the lips and the moving of the rosary. Yes, she was beautiful. She was like the winter landscape in the mountains, an expanse of pure white serenity, breathing peace and contentment. So for few minutes, we are learning about the appearance of the grandmother. She was fat, she was bent, and she was wearing a spotless white dress. Her hand was resting on her waist and she had an hobbled walk. She was walking unsteadily and in one hand she had a rosary. Rosary means prayer beads. She was saying prayers. Her silver locks, her gray hair, it was not combed properly, were scattered untidily over her pale, puckered face. She was pale as she has grown old. She was pale. Puckered means wrinkled face. And her lips constantly moved in inaudible prayer. Inaudible means not audible. Velila and the chattam kekala, inaudible prayer. But as I said in the previous paragraph, she was not pretty, but she was beautiful. Again, the writer says, the narrator says, yes, she was beautiful. How beautiful was she? She was like a winter landscape in the mountains. See, we have seen mountains covered with the snow, white snow. Now this old lady was so beautiful as the mountains covered with snow. An expanse of pure, expanse means a very vast space of pure white serenity. Serenity is calmness. Breathing peace and contentment. She was much satisfied with the life she has led. Or dhripti, contentment means dhripti. Serenity, calmness, amaydi. Breathing peace. She was not worried. As we see many old ladies grumbling, shouting at their grandchildren and fighting with their daughter-in-law. But this old lady was not so. She was so beautiful. How beautiful was she? She was like a winter landscape in the mountains, an expanse of pure white serenity, calmness, breathing peace and contentment. She was very peaceful, and above all, contentment means she was very satisfied. She was not grumbling of her life. She was not grumbling of her grandchildren. She was not murmuring about her daughter-in-law. Nothing. She was leading a very, very peaceful and content life.